In this video, we are going to compare containers and virtual machines. On the screen, you can see like a little diagram regarding the infrastructure and like the architect of these two things. We'll go into what are the details and what do all these things represent, and how do they compare with each other. So containers and virtual machines, they have a similar resource isolation and like the allocation benefits that they provide. But the functioning part is a little bit different, because in containers, they virtualize the operating system instead of the hardware. And containers are like much more portable and efficient, as we looked into the previous video. So on the screen, you can see something like, in the left hand side, you can see containerized applications, app A, app B, app C, app D. Then there's something called Docker over here, host operating system, and then the infrastructure or your hardware. So containers, in simple terms, they are basically abstracting at the app layer. So basically they package the code and the dependencies together. Multiple containers can, run on the same machine. And the important part over here is the thing we mentioned in the previous video, is that they are sharing the host operating system. The OS kernel is, being shared by all the above containers. So it's not like installing a new operating system on its own. No, it's using the host operating system. And each particular app that you see on the screen, app A, app B, app C, app D, it's running in an isolated environment. These are like isolated processes. Obviously, you can communicate with each other, but it's like does not really have much information related to what is going on, let's say, in the host operating system outside it. So this is great because you're not installing, let's say, the entire operating system. Containers are taking less space and, than a virtual machine, for example, which we'll talk more about later. And it's basically like images, and which we'll also look into later, what are images and stuff. They take like a few megabytes of size, and they can handle, more applications and require fewer VMs and like operating systems, basically. On the other hand, in the right-hand side, you can see virtual machine. Virtual machine basically provides an abstraction of the physical hardware. So turning one particular server into multiple servers. So literally like you divide the hard disk space and install separate operating systems on that. You might have done like dual booting on stuff. So like Windows on one part of the hard disk, some Linux distro like Ubuntu or something on another part. So that is on the hardware level that is happening. What is a hypervisor, you may ask, in the diagram that you may see? So hypervisor is nothing. It's just like a machine monitor, a virtual machine monitor. So it's just a software that allows you to create and run virtual machines. And the role is that basically it allows the host computer, or like the main servers, to support multiple guest virtual machines by sharing its resources. For example, if you want to share the memory, the space and the processing power, all these things can be shared with different operating systems. So each virtual machine, it's like literally a full copy of an entire operating system. The application, all the necessary binaries and all the libraries and stuff, this takes up to like tens of GBs and all these things. And also, in order to boot this up, it can be like a little slow as well. If you're using Civo cloud, you can run up instances in like less than 2 minutes. So most definitely check it out, check that out. We have an entire course on like how to use a Civo CLI and stuff as well, so that will come later on. But that is like the most the main differences between a container and a virtual machine. It's not a this or that question. People often ask, should I use containers or virtual machines? Because it's like containers and virtual machines are used together. They provide a lot of great flexibility in terms of like deploying and managing. So in short, like you can say that containers run on top of virtual machines, for example. That's totally fine. So it's not a this or that question. Both of these things are being used. Thanks a lot for watching. See you in the next videos.